I'm Linda Kemp, and I'd like to show you an alternative approach to painting. If you're like most watercolor painters, you begin your landscapes with a sketch and then fill in your shapes with color and texture. It's typical to start at the top and progress down the painting to the bottom. Painting landscape in the negative, however, requires quite a different strategy. You'll be working in reverse. Start at the bottom and work to the top, and instead of filling in your shapes, you'll be painting around them. First, let's look at a couple of symbols that might represent a tree. On the left, we're not very convinced that this would be a tree. All of the branches would be the same size and come out from the trunk at the same angle. On the right-hand side, we see a symbol that more accurately represents a tree. We have a trunk and branches that break off at different angles and in different positions. It's really important that we create a symbol that conveys the idea of a tree to our viewer. In this sample, you'll see the same image or the same symbol repeated a number of times. I've flipped it and I've shifted it back. It's changing in value from light to middle to dark. Some of the shapes are smaller and they shift in position and change direction. I've prepared a little underpainting using a wet and wet technique, and it's already dry, so we're off to a good start. The colors that I've used are raw umber, cerulean blue, raw sienna, and I've also added just a touch of phthalo blue. I'll be using that later on. I'm going to start carving out some of my trees using the same colors that I have in my underpainting. I'm working upside down, starting at the base of the tree and glazing around it. And I'm going to branch off here, wash the color away. Very delicate glaze of color. There we go, there's the first little break for a major limb from the trunk. I'm back to the trunk, pull the color up. Let's work on the other side of the tree. Another limb, and down the right side of the tree. Washing the color away as I go. There's lots of time later to cut into the branches. I just want to get the major limbs in at this point. We're building in layers. The trees that are closest to us will be carved out first. Let's pull a branch off that one. It's really straight side on that one. A little bit of color. Now, I want to make sure that this trunk is either thicker or thinner than the first one. Let's make a nice thin one. There we go. Angling off with the trunk, or with off from the trunk with a branch at a slightly different angle and in a different location, a little lower down the tree. The tree's going to taper as it moves up to the top. Oh, got some paint and things here. Pull that cerulean blue down. All right, there we go. Let's put one more little skinny tree on this side. I began this row of trees a little ways up on the painting rather than starting at the bottom because I want to show the trees going off into the distance. Okay, there's my first layer. Now I'd like to show you how I'll progress up the page working into the back to develop the layers of trees as we move into the forest. To suggest distance or a deep interior, the layers progress upward in tiers from the bottom to the top. Consider that the picture plane is a shallow stage. Each layer is a flat screen laying one behind the other. You can see that the layers of the trees move further into the distance and they rise up and back, much like climbing a set of stairs. So the next layer will begin by stepping up the page so it appears to be back in the distance. I'll use the same colors again and start my next layer of trees. This is going to be a little darker as we move into the distance, and I'll paint out, carving out the next tree. You want to make sure you include a lot of different widths of your trees, and you also want to focus on having different spacing. At this point, these are all the same. So I'll have to keep that in mind when I'm working. This limb goes behind this tree and it'll pull up here. All right, you can continue to work and build up as many layers, getting as intricate as you like, but I think you've got the idea, and I'd like to move on to a landscape painting now.